e-bike is an assisted bicycle, typically has a battery and some form of motor that will either propel the bicycle forward or can assist a rider.
One of the major concerns I've seen when people turning down the idea of e-bikes is for the range.
I know that batteries are typically the limiting technology with a lot of electric vehicles. With electric bikes and with electric cars, it limits the amount of range it can get.
The e-bike challenge is designed to foster innovations in building e-bikes with new or expanded features. One of those aims is to extend the overall range of the bicycle to 125 miles, which realistically no commercial bicycle under 30 kilograms is capable of doing at this point.
Electric bikes are very ubiquitous nowadays, and so if you came up with a design and has this tremendous range of 125 miles, that could potentially be a leader in terms of electric bike design. I wanted to create an opportunity for our engineering students to design for the real world. 125 miles is not easy to do, considering that these bikes, we limited the weight to 30 kilograms.
We wanted to build a power summing gear train using a planetary gear set that used two different inputs and a single output.
It has an onboard motor that acts as a generator. So our bike has two motors, a hub motor that propels it from the rear, and then a mid-drive generator motor that we basically built from scratch. It allows the rider to generate electricity as they're pedaling and extend the life of their battery.
The most special thing about our bike is that it has a huge battery pack. Another special feature about our bike is that there's lots of carbon fiber parts. It also utilizes the latest 3D printing material.
We started with a prototype that we were already designing in the lab, and once we heard about the challenge, we realized that we can scale up this prototype to go 125 miles. The prototype was basically a small-scale bike that we designed to accommodate for high efficiency and road comfort.
The technology of our bike, first of all, is a battery pack. The trouble we had is how to fit so many batteries in our bike. Our solution is we specifically went for a bike frame that is affordable, but at the same time, it has enough space to enclose all the batteries, and it can have enough space for the sensor pool. The sensor pool we have, we include the current voltage sensors, temperature sensors, and GPS.
We are doing the 125 miles in the context of 125 years of the Clark School of Engineering. The first 100 miles would be indoors. So we have these programmable indoor trainers that will measure the power that's being outputted and the range and so on. First 50 miles would be nothing but the motor itself. The second 50 miles is the motor plus a rider. The cool thing is that you can actually program the trainers so that it simulates just about any route that you want. Now, the route we did, it's from here, College Park, the University of Maryland, Baltimore. Now, for the third part, they went through campus under real world conditions. It's about 4.4 miles, and so they did six laps. I was really quite surprised because I thought that I had seen a lot of electric bike design over the years. But in this competition, I have seen designs that I have never seen before. As a matter of fact, the winner is truly innovative. And I don't think that that system exists, to my knowledge, anywhere in the world. The other big surprise for me is how well these students actually manage how to get a task done between classes and, you know, the normal things that students do. They found the energy, the teamwork to work together. And that's the essence, I think, of engineering teamwork. And that's what I'm very pleased to see.